thanks everyone. Get stuck.
Recording in progress.
Like to ask a question, please let us know. Max Boltman.
Nick, what do you think the emotions will be like tonight playing former team for the first time?
I think a lot of excitement. For me personally, I've played with most of those guys for north of 5 years, and I think the long playoff runs and some of the tougher years, and then some of the great years we had together. I think all those memories and bonds, are huge, and I think a lot of excitement.
When you've kind of been through an experience like that with a group of guys, going from, I think you were there when Tavares left, and then right through back-to-back final appearance. Like, I have to imagine those are some of the kind of strongest burning memories you got there.
Yeah, I mean, it could be anything from team get-togethers to the bubble to the long playoff runs. That's when I think you grow as a team, and being there 7 years and getting to really know those guys, it was a special moment or special moments. And like I said, it's going to be exciting. I think probably have a little nerves out there, but I've always had a great time playing against friends, and it'll be even better to play against some very good friends.
For you guys, I mean, what's worked for you guys out here on this last stretch where I think it's 4 straight now wins?
I think, we've had great goaltending. They've come up huge for us in the times we need them. And I think we're really starting to figure out, how to win. There may be some times and some stretches in the games where we're not playing our best, but we're competing and working hard, and we're finding ways to win.
Thank you.
Daniel Bruce.
Nick, have you had any time to catch up with any of your former teammates? Do you guys get to get dinner or anything like that?
Yeah, I grabbed dinner with some of the guys last night, so it was great to catch up. And, with all the stuff that they've been going through, it was great to see them all and obviously healthy. So, it was great to catch up and get together with them.
And Nick, you've recently hit some career milestones in playing in your 800th game, but most recently you actually are viral on TikTok right now. As of yesterday, you had 1.5 million views. Now you've got almost 3.5 million. How'd you do it?
Whew. I don't know. I don't even have Instagram or any social media, so I don't know how that's even possible. But I saw the one with JR the other day, and I only heard about the wrestling match that was ensued yesterday in practice. So I assume that's the other one, but. It's those guys are goofballs and they keep me young too.
You and JR playing in your he played in his 1000th game, and then you and your 800th. Seems like the veteran experience is kind of working there for you guys.
yeah for sure.
Thank you, Nick.
Yeah.
Andrew Gross.
Hey, well, it's great to see you.
Good to see you.
Yeah, good to see you. I don't know how closely you're following the Islanders this season. Is there any irony to you that the one thing they really seem to be lacking is a puck-moving defenseman?
Oh, I don't know. I think, that's a special group in there. They know how to win. They've shown it over the past number of years. And I think with the COVID stretch and playing on the road for so long to start the season, those are not easy experiences. And I think for them, it'll only make this team stronger and grow as a team for them.
Do you sort of look at them coming in tonight kind of as a wounded tiger or whatever analogy you want to... You don't want to be the team that they get well against?
Well, I think you look at that lineup up and down. Obviously, a lot of skill. Playing on the team, they're very good defensively, so... we're going to have to capitalize on our chances and limit theirs as well. So, any team can win on any given night in this league, and it's no different with them.
Trevor Thompson.
Nick, I don't know how closely you followed, what's going on over there, but obviously you have friends in that locker room, and you talked about what they've been through this year in so many different ways. What are your thoughts on what you've seen from afar, from what they're going through, and how it's impacted where they're at in the standings?
you know, like I said, I think they're still a good team, very good team. They went to the conference finals twice in the past 2 years, so obviously not a team you want to take lightly, and obviously we want to have a good start and try and get on them early, and like I said, try and limit their chances and creating some momentum.
And just on a personal side, any way you felt about what you've seen them go through off the ice? And thanks.
Well, obviously, you never want to see them go through stretches like that. Especially with the COVID stuff, it's always a little bit of a scare. And, you know, I got very good buddies over there. So obviously it was great to see that everything was good there on that side. And, you know, obviously it's going to be a fun time tonight.
Thanks, everyone. Be back shortly with Coach Blaschel.